The live case from Jaydeva Institute of Medical Sciences.
Thank you.
Good evening, everybody.
I request Dr. Vijayalakshmi to come.
Dr. Nageshwar is there or?
Yeah, Jai Ranganath, Nageshwar here. And we have Shivakumar, Dr. Joshna and Dr. Vijayalakshmi also is coming.
Ha, Nageshwar, good evening.
How are you doing?
Okay.
Go ahead with the case presentation.
Good evening, everybody. Yeah, I'm fine, Nagesh. Here we have Dr. K. Srinivas with me, Dr. Anand, our anesthetist, Mr. Mohan, Saira, Govardhan. So we'll start away, the case straight away. He's a 21-year-old male. This is a straightforward coarctation. A bit of background is there. Effort intolerance for last 6 months, lower limb claudication. At infancy, he was diagnosed to have a VSD with a PDA with a coarctation. Coarctation repair and PDA ligation was done at the 2 months of age. VSD was not treated. That was almost about 20 years ago. So he did not undergo any procedure later. So next slide. He is cyanotic, he is clubbed, upper limb blood pressure 170/80, radiofemoral delay. That means a clear cut Eisenmenger with saturation of 80 to 85, completely right to left
pressure lines too, just
across the VST. So he is inoperable as far as VSD is concerned. The ECG shows a right axis deviation, bit of left ventricular forces. Next slide. I don't think you will be able to appreciate much of a rib notching and all here. Next slide. This echo which shows, you could easily see that RVH, a large subaortic VST with a predominantly right to left shunty. Next. Next.
It looks like a doubly committed VST.
In the suprastural view, this echocardiography which shows. Yeah. So this is recoarctation, who has undergone the coarct repair surgically at the age of 2 months of age. Next slide. With a gradient now, an echo gradient is around 55 to 60. Next. You could see the.
Yeah, it's there. CT angio, yeah.
CT angio. As a pre-procedural, as a plan, we got a CT angiogram, done a discrete coarctation with a proximal, I was measuring around 20 to 22 millimeter, distal to coarctation is measuring around 24 millimeter. Are you able to see the hemodynamics? There is a significant gradient around 70 to 80 millimeters of mercury.
Have the camera on the screen? Yeah.
Yeah, I could see that. So this is a very classical coarctation hemodynamic tracing.
Is not showing. Is there ductus arteriosus? Did you? It looks like there is a PDA as well. No, close?
No.
There is no duct.
Because I can see kind of.
There is no duct.
There is no duct. Yeah, PDA has been ligated during the first surgery.
Okay. PDA has been ligated.
We'll do the angiogram. That will clearly tell us about the status of the PDA. Yeah.
So show the angiogram. We have done the angiogram. It was a very straightforward thing to cross the.
Srinivas, if the PDA was ligated earlier, was the coarctation also repaired earlier? Is it a restenosis?
Yes.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it is a restenosis. It is a recoarctation. Initially, subclavian patch angioplasty has been done in infancy along with PDA ligation. VSD was not treated at that point of time.
So we have got
subsequently
case.
There was we don't have the exact clinical data why during the follow up VSD closure was not done in the follow up period. We don't have complete records about that.
So here is a case of Eisenmenger with recoarctation. Dr. Nagesh.
Yes, it looks very interesting.
Yeah, Nagesh Rao, yeah, you could discuss.
Yeah, we have
about
got an Eisenmenger syndrome here, which is quite inoperable, as well as we have got a coarctation of aorta. So there are a lot of questions here. Eisenmenger syndrome is anyway inoperable. Why should we operate to coarctation of aorta? And if there is a biventricular dysfunction, whether to deal the coarctation of aorta? These are the set of questions probably will arise. Probably we can discuss these issues. What, Shivakumar?
Jay, I think your intention to stent this coarctation is to relieve the left and right ventricular systolic hypertension. which is caused by the coarctation, correct?
Yes.
So,
yes.
I mean,
claudication. Plus, he has claudication, which is quite significant.
Okay.
Yeah. Disabling claudication. Yeah.
Okay.
The now, whatever we are doing, Shivkumar, I think Shiva, this is just a palliative procedure that we are very, very clear about it.
I understand. The so whether are you going to anticipate some fall in the aortic saturation after you relieve this coarctation? The patient is saturating 82% with a central cyanosis.
I don't anticipate.
With the
really anticipate.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, I think the situation is Eisenminger syndrome is there. If you take the natural history of Eisenminger syndrome, which is not very really bad, they don't die at second decade and third decade. But in the presence of coarctation, I think biventricular dysfunction is going to happen very fast. And we are not going to prepare this patient anyway for the future VST closure. I think symptomatic relief is very important here to prolong the survival. And I don't know why he did not develop collaterals. Probably it's a post-coarctation which was done during infancy. Collaterals are not well developed. That's why there's a claudication, it seems. So I think you are thinking of dealing the coarctation looks
very
good
likely.
Here. Probably we do agree. If there are any questions, we can probably take it.
Now, Dr. Nageshwar Rao, only thing is that he is, as you said, that he is just 21 years of age. With the available the medicine, the pharmacotherapy right now, with the combination of phosphodiesterase inhibitors and endothelial receptor antagonists, I think his quality of life will improve in any Eisenminger syndrome anyway. In this case, if you allow this coarctation to be like this, I think there will be a rapid progression of his LV dysfunction, biventricular dysfunction. So probably we are looking at just a quality of improvement, quality of life improvement, rather than any kind of a definitive procedure here.
Jairanganath, what I wanted to point out was in a VSD Eisenminger, it is the high pulmonary vascular resistance which is causing the right left shunt. And your left right shunt is now contributed by a tight coarctation.
Yeah.
Once you relieve the coarctation, the right left shunt may get more prominent and the aortic saturation may fall further. So I have dealt with the same situation, and there was a 10-15% fall in the aortic saturation following a successful coarctation stenting, because now there is some amount of left-right shunt caused by the coarctation, some amount of right-left shunt caused by the high pulmonary vascular disease, and you are relieving one of them. So, I mean, that is one of the questions what I asked, whether do you anticipate a fall in the aortic saturation. But I agree with your concepts. I think you should go ahead and stent this coarctation and try to...
I did think about that. We probably might increase the right-left shunting. I thought about it. But we thought that we'll give a try with at least to improve some of his symptoms. His main symptom is actually he's come to the hospital for intermittent claudication. I don't know how far it is true because of this coarctation, but that is his main complaint right now.
Yeah. Actually, in a similar situation, when I stented a coarctation about 5 years ago, the saturation dropped from the high 80s to like almost like 70s.
Heparin, please. High 80s to 70s, okay.
Okay, let us see what happens.
Okay, let us see the angiogram. We have just finished the angiogram.
So it was crossing this coarct is not very difficult because it's a good antegrade flow. You can use any catheter. We used a Judkin's rod with a termo wire. And put a pictile, marker pictile. Next view. So this is a steep LAO, almost LAO 75, lateral, dead lateral. You could see the discrete coarctation there.
No, it can't be 10. It's so huge. Marker pictine is 10 millimeters. No, not
okay, next.
I'm asking
next.
How much is the size?
20 millimeters
told.
So is left subclavian.
This is the anteroposterior projection. Okay. Next view. This is a LAO, just go back to the previous view. Here we know where the carotid and the innominate are.
Right. in the pre-coaptation
segment, we don't see any ductus here.
Aneurysmal bulge on the undersurface of the aorta.
Dr. Srinivas,
okay,
in this angio, the pre-coact there is aneurysmal bulge. Yeah. The post-coact there is post-aortic dilatation.
Go
so what
the
are the sizes
lateral
on both the sides,
lateral view, lateral
before
view.
And after the coact?
Yeah.
There is a pouch.
No, the CT was measuring around 22 to 23 pre, madam. Post was measuring 24 CT angiogram.
The pre is 20.
As all of you can see that there is no left subclavian artery.
22.
Subclavian flap angioplasty, and it looks like there's
post-aortic segment is 24. I mean 22.
Aneurysm there. Maybe that's where the subclavian artery flap was anastomosed.
What are the measurements?
Nageshwara?
Yeah, it looks like
22 and 24, ma'am. Proximal to the coact, it is 22. Distal to the coact, it is 24 on CT. And even by this pigtail marker, you can get a rough idea it is more than 22. I mean, more than 20.
So, Jai, what is your strategy based on this dimensions that you have got?
So, Shiva, what do you suggest?
You need to.
That is what I. That's what I was about to ask you.
The
pre-coaptation. We should do?
The pre-coaptation distal transverse arch.
I'll tell you what we have here.
Bulge on the undersurface, and you have a diameter of close to 20 millimeters. So you need to use a stent which will be dilatable to 20 millimeter. And only we have to use either a 4014 or
exactly.
An intra-stent mega with a 20 millimeter.
That is
20 or 22 would be.
No, see, I don't have a CP. We don't have a CP stent here.
No, are we not considering cover stent here? Cover TP or Adventa 16, and which can be dilatable up to 20 plus.
The if the coarctation diameter to the final diameter.
No, the problem with Adventa is we get maximum sizes.
16. I think you can use a Gaudi's 4014 stent.
Maximum diameter we get is 16 millimeter. The moment you try to dilate more, that's what we are doing, Shiva. That's what we are planning to use the 5014 probably. You have taken a 5014.
What about CP stent? Because Gaudi's stent, it's a little bit more rigid stent in transverse arch, distal arch location, bit uncomfortable because stent will not align as per the arch anatomy. Maybe CP stent, I feel, is a little bit more, will be aligned.
Well, CP is not available. However, I feel that...
we don't have it.
And moreover, there is aneurysmal sac, and it is like acute angle.
Nageshwar Rao, I completely agree with you. Best stent for coarctation is a CP stent. But we don't have the CP stent today here. What we have is a atrium stent, Adventa, and the Cardi stents. So we have decided to use the 5014 Cardi stent.
Okay.
Yeah, we have
mounted it on it.
As the Shiva was discussing, I don't think we should do any.
What are the balloons?
18 millimeter. Atlas 18 millimeter, 4 centimeter.
We are using Atlas.
Atlas.
Atlas balloon. 18 mm diameter. Come behind
Atlas is a very high pressure balloon. It is very useful in pushing the stent to very high pressures.
Yeah.
But one of the problem of an Atlas balloon 18 into, are you taking an 18 into 4?
Correct.
Is it a 18 into 4 Atlas?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, 18 into 4 will have a 3.5 centimeter taper
yeah.
in the front centimeter taper at the, it has got huge shoulders. However, it grips the stent very well.
So, are you seeing the fluoro now, Shiva?
Hello?
Yeah.
Shiva, are you seeing the fluoro or what now?
We are seeing the fluoro.
Are you seeing the fluoro?
We are seeing some sheath in the
right. Now, we are
right
taking the stent
artery.
In. Yeah, yeah.
Dr. Jairangnath, I don't see the pacing lead. Are you
we
not
have placed
going
the guide
to keep
wire
the
in the
lead?
Right nominate.
What size of, what French of sheath, Jairangnath?
No, madam, we are not using. This is a 12 left sheath.
12 French Lifetech braided sheath we are using.
Okay.
See, a couple of things for the people there, I think. Nageshwara, you just discussed the strategies how to.
Dr. Jairangnath, the pacing would be safer, no? Because in case this is a short stent, in case it moves with the thing, then we may land in trouble, no?
Yeah.
No, I'm just wondering.
No, I have a venous line here.
The balloon.
What do you think, Shri Nageshwara? I have a venous line. You want us to pace?
No, I think it's safer to
contrast
pace because of the transverse arch location, which you are.
And plus the anatomy is such that it might slip and then.
I'm just wondering, are there balloon marks on, balloon marks are there? Because the distal portion looks like a stent is exactly a balloon marker.
Balloon marks are there.
Facing electrode.
It's a 18x4 balloon and
see,
it's
a 5014 balloon.
It's one
balloon is 5014 stent. That's why it is hanging in front. Correct. 1 centimeter longer.
Correct, but it's a tapering balloon. It's not a uniformly 18 millimeter.
But that is an advantage here because the proximal is narrow and distance is.
Jairanganath, I'll just tell you one small problem that may happen. You are having a long tapering front shoulder.
Okay.
And that front shoulder is on the innominate artery. And as you keep inflating the balloon in the innominate artery, sometimes the balloon may sort of balance it backwards because the whole 18 millimeter may not be accommodated in the denominator artery if the denominator artery is not as big. So I mean, just be a little bit more. As you are inflating the balloon, try to keep the sheath as high as possible to push the, give a sort of a counter pressure on the balloon to retain it in the coarctation segment.
Yes, yes, that's our
reason. That's a very good trip. Problem, why can't we keep the wire as well?
This is exactly we intend to do,
No, Jairanganath, rather anticipating that problem, I saw the balloon actually going ahead of this stent. Just wondering, why can't we keep the guide wire itself in the ascending aorta?
Yeah.
That's a good tip.
That's a good point.
Yeah, that we can do
we
that.
We could do that even now, we could do that. Yeah, it's a good. We'll just do both the pacing. We could have avoided it.
Shiva, if you have a CP cover stent, do you recommend this particular scenario? Why you are not considering?
One is
I reserve the covered stents for extremely tight coarctation or very, very tortuous segments. Otherwise, a bare stent normally gives a reasonably good result. If you see the diameter of the coarctation,
I think we may take the wire into this. That's not an issue, shall we? Ascending aorta? Okay, that's a good point.
No, but this is not that sort of aneurysm where you want to keep it away. This is only a portion of it is.
Shall I pull the wire back? Shall I pull the wire back?
We may not be able to approximate the stent on all so the places with the covered CP.
No, it's fine. That's correct. That's fine. Yeah, shall I pull the wire?
That's more rigid.
Oh, that is moving this.
Or shall we take?
No, this you have to push back.
What was the size of the innominate artery, Jairanganath? Do you remember?
I'm taking the wire so that we go more into the.
I don't remember.
No, if the innominate artery is not a very small artery and if it is very large and aneurysmal, then nothing will happen. Otherwise, it will get melanceded down. Repositioning.
No,
it's quite big, I suppose, but I'm not very sure.
Maybe big.
I think it is going there repeatedly. It's going into. I think we'll just keep it there. I think.
You come out, come down, Jay. You still have got a lot of space between the coarctation and your.
Should be fine.
Come down a little bit below and then advance the wire.
Yeah.
In these adults with coarctation, it may not be a bad idea to put in a right radial 5-French sheath, put in a pigtail in the transverse arch, and then you know that where the stent is moving around.
The position is better evaluated.
I'm not able to.
Now we advance the little bit.
It's going to carotid now. It's going to.
It is going to the carotid. Left carotid.
Let's turn it a bit this side. Go to the lateral.
Now maybe we'll take it out and then. Take it out and put a Judkins.
Okay.
Yeah, the stent, the stent can be taken out and then.
Taking it out, the stent at the hub is a problem. At the hub.
No, no, we're going to do that.
Come to the hub.
Yeah.
Yeah, the, okay. Must have, come.
See, the problem that we are, Dr. Jay is trying to show is that, you know, if we are going to be inflating the balloon across the transverse arch with the distal, the proximal end of the balloon within the innominate artery, as your balloon is getting inflated, sometimes the balloon may get melon seeded out into more and more distal portions of the arch, and then we might miss out the lesion. And
that's
the
common thing, you know, because there is no space in innominate. And there is aorta, there is more. So it naturally it slips back into the aorta.
Strong people on the day. Yeah. Fine.
This is a better one.
Yeah.
Okay, do go some more. Yeah, fine.
Jayanagnath, okay. This so appears to be a little better position now.
Okay, give this.
The wire can be there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fine. Yeah.
Anchoring would be better.
No, my thing was that if you.
Yen martinna. Avair mele hoganamma. We'll go on that wire. Yes, yes. Just. In the kerkuma.
No, no, okay.
Nidan, nidana. Nidan, nidana.
Okay, push the wire.
Okay.
What way?
Okay, fluoro. Fluoro, just see. I think we are there. Just go, fluoro. Go on, fluoro. Yeah. See this. Good enough. Good enough. Just go. Okay.
Okay, go to lateral, please.
Give me the indiflator.
So most important in coarctation stenting is that you have to get this sheath across the coarctate segment.
Okay, kudi. Okay, sir. Contrast fully dema. Volume ako mainon sulpa. Put some more volume. Load some more volume. Always you have to take more volume with diluted contrast.
Need some contrast here.
Yeah, we'll do that. Okay, just a small bubble. Small bubble. Yeah, enough. Okay. Okay, I think you can exit, and only after you exit we'll be able to check the sheath injection. Yeah. Exit.
Or the same view.
Yeah, same view, lateral view, please. Yeah. Okay, now you may pull back the sheath for the injection. Pull back the sheath for the injection. Have that roadmap. Yeah. It's leaking out here. Oh.
We'll be making one angiogram here.
Not getting the injection. Okay.
Oh, the thing is that
we are having some problem.
Leaking.
I think we may have to take another sheath on the femoral.
Sheath is leaking. I'm not able to give the injection.
No, I think once it comes out,
just
we'll be able
I wanted to tell you one thing.
Below the stent.
In this coarctation stenting, preferable to take a Cook sheath where the check flow valve is very good, because we may have to have a good injection.
That's a new one.
And I did that. What happened? Sure, I did
contrast,
that.
Please.
What happened was that was got kinking. You know, it was not a braided sheath.
Okay.
So it got king, so I had to change it.
Okay.
Yeah, now we are fine. Yeah.
Okay, take one picture here.
One more, we'll have a little more contrast, please.
Little more contrast. That I had to remove that sheath and put this sheath.
I understand.
This valve is very bad, usually this
the Cook sheaths, there was a lot of kink in that, so we had to take it out here.
Yeah, Cook's braided sheaths are called flexor sheaths.
We have to come down.
Good picture.
I think the stent has to come back a bit.
Yeah, flexor sheaths, yeah, that we didn't get. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that. Now some more contrast, please. Yeah.
I think that's a better position, no?
Okay.
Yeah, the position is
you could come back a little bit.
Yeah, the position
more.
Appears to all right.
Back a little bit more. little bit more.
Okay.
I'll take another scene.
I'll take one more scene.
It's not a bad idea to
I think that should be fine.
The so yeah. Then we'll go for pacing and then we'll do that. Okay. Is it okay, Nagesh?
Deep line, keep it pushed.
Some more, because
some more contrast.
Because
having drawn it, I just want to be very sure.
Push the sheath down several times.
Sheath has to come down.
Shall I?
Okay.
Position is fine.
Okay. Shall I?
So that there's a place for the balloon to inflate.
Okay,
I think the
yeah.
position is fine,
yeah,
and you can go ahead.
Good position, actually.
Yeah.
Okay. Rapid iterative pacing. Who is taking care?
So then we'll use a ventricular pacing.
Yeah. The sheath has to come down even a little bit more, a little bit down, because the shoulder will be even longer than this. Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah. And keep the balloon pushed inside.
Very long.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. I think.
Yeah. They're all very important steps. Yeah.
You are using an indiflator or your hand?
Indiflator.
So we are pacing.
Okay.
Indiflator.
Indiflator.
See, yeah.
Keep it pushed.
Keep the forward thing.
Keep it pushed. 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 Keep it pushed.
Okay.
Fine.
That's fine.
Remove the pacing.
Migrated a little bit.
Pacing off.
Fortunate that we are still within the.
Though it came fine. Back, but still there is fine. A part of
no,
it.
No, it's fine. It's got the.
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah,
we are well
within
it.
It's migrated, but constriction is there.
That's a good thing. The waist is rightly formed. His hand is on the way, yeah.
But that way it will hold it.
Just have a look at his pulse.
No, he's fine.
He had a. It is fine, it's perfect.
Yeah.
Positioning is perfect, yeah. Be careful. Feel the pulse.
Though it migrated a bit, but still it is in
it
a
we are not inflating
good position.
Anymore.
That's
it
a good, appears
well.
Good.
Carefully take it out. Carefully take the sheath inside. Yeah. You saved that. Eagle,
okay.
I don't know. No, you take the full thing out.
Balloon. Wait, let the wire be there.
1 second. Be there.
Yeah. We are taking the balloon out.
Pressure, please. Is the pressure okay? I think we'll have to take back the wire because it's kinked up. Yeah.
Okay, remove the balloon. Remove the wire.
Okay, 1 second. Yeah, fine. Okay, it's getting bent. We take it out.
Are you going to show us the pressure or the angio?
Yeah. Pressure, madam. Both.
Jairanga, we are interested
pressure
in saturation. Shokumar was.
As we.
What is the saturation now?
Is patient on oxygen or?
What is the saturation?
Are you giving oxygen?
It must be.
Yeah.
The proximal aortic pressure now is the same. What is the saturation?
Saturation is 84%.
Very good.
We can see Mohan brother there nicely. Hello, brother.
It could give the indiflator, please.
It's
I mean this angio mat.
No pressure. Connect to the pressure.
Pressure is shown already.
No, both simultaneously.
Is it 140?
Okay, then you sheath, you have to pull down. Sheath, you have to pull back.
One second,
ma'am, we'll give the
simultaneous.
Simultaneous
pressure will give you.
Fluoro. Okay. It is equalized. Both are around 140. Around 130/86. Yeah, get ready for the angio.
No gradient.
You can freeze that. And freeze that, brother.
Sats are around 85/86.
Freeze it, brother.
Sir, back. Okay, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll do an angiogram now.
It's okay. We're coming to an end.
Yes, go ahead.
Go ahead and do the angiogram.
Connect. Brother.
We are left with only 30 seconds.
Yeah.
I think you are left with 30 seconds to
aspirate,
do the angio
please.
So that we can clap for
aspirate.
You.
Aspirate.
Aspirate.
Yeah, fine. Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Okay. Yes, Sine. It's fine. It's perfectly positioned.
Excellent result.
Some more contrast properly.
Still the stent is a little bit still covering the aneurysm.
I think it's a reasonably good result with no hemodynamic gradient.
Yeah, it's a good result. See, since the balloon partially came back, the proximal end of the stent is slightly narrower. However, being a bad stent, we just can leave the stent as such. Our intention was to make only ascending aorta to descending aorta zero gradient, and that is achieved.
And Dr. Nageshwar has point, you know, this is a little stiff stent. It doesn't take the shape.
Yes.
So you can see that the stent is holding like this, whereas the descending is coming like that.
I have seen one of the follow-up patient of these kind of stents. Actually,
there is a shoulder in the descending aorta. Yeah.
The distal portion where
it's going like that. It's standing like this.
2 o'clock, 3 o'clock position. That particular area.
So you can see that it is
potentially dangerous to erode the aorta.
You can literally see that it is jutting out, you know, the lower thing. I think CP stent would have been better option.
Fluoro.
So that's a good result. So introduce the team.
Any questions from the audience on the floor? Any questions would you like to convey to Dr. Jayarangana and team, Dr. Srinivasan? So, what are the medications you are going to start, Jayarangana? The question of any oral antiplatelets to this?
Just to
bring some.
No, oral antiplatelets we are going to give him. But along with that, he is already on that sildenafil and other vasodilators. Yeah.
Okay.
So thank you very much, Dr. Jayarangana and Srinivas and the whole team. Let us all give a big hand to them.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jayarangana. We congratulate you, your team, whoever is there with you.